Are we ready to do Cooking with SonicBlu tonight? Well, after our MTV special, I'm pretty sure you're ready for some good eating, too. Little news flash for Ranger Stormwolf. Unfortunately, I was missing out on one ingredient, so unfortunately, we'll have to put your recipe a little bit further on the back burner, but that's okay. Back burner. You get it? Cooking? Back burner? Okay, it's a cooking joke. Come on, laugh it up. You know what I... What? What? What is that? Never mind. All right. Okay, today I'm going to give a very interesting recipe. Today we're going to do some Mexican food, okay? But I'm going to do it in a way where we have never done it before. You saw how I made chicken fajita pitas, and you saw me making carne asada burritos. Well, today we're going to mix them both together and see what we come up with. But instead of chicken, we got some real choice cuts of carne. This is your meat. And over here, we have our lechuga, or lettuce, that's going into the pita. We got our cebollas, or onion, that's going to be going into the skillet over here for sautéing. As a matter of fact, let's get to some of this onion over here and start sautéing and turn this on to a medium-high, about 7. I'm going to use a little bit of this stuff here. This is vegetable oil. So we're just going to use a little bit of dab of vegetable oil, not too much. Just enough to sauté the onion, and we're going to throw more onion in there too. Now this little bowl here is what we're going to be using to put our onion away when we do the meat. You know how I love cooking with lime. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this lime, squirt it into that skillet. When those onions are done sautéing, we're going to toss the meat in there with this lime, and it's going to taste real good. Real authentic Mexican food. They always cook with lima. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Well, you know what I'm talking about? Hey, yeah. That's Italian. All right. Now, we got Pico de Gallo, which consists of, now you remember when I made my carne asada burritos, I made some homemade pico de gallo sauce, and if you don't remember how I made it, check out the recipe on ohiopawpets.org. Basically what it is chopped onion, chopped tomato, and cilantro. Now you can also use the cilantro base if you want to, but this time I forgot to pick that up too. So unfortunately we are devoid of our cilantro base, so we're just having straight pico de gallo. There it is, and looks beautiful. Look at that. Now I have a whole onion that I threw in there, but I should have used one of these onions. These are the smaller yellow onions, as opposed to the big kahuna over here that I threw an entire one of these in there. And now if you use a smaller portion, that would have been an awesome pico de gallo. So get as much onion, muchas cebollas, as possible. Now this should be good for a start right here. This is a good amount for the amount of meat that we got over here. This is a whole medium yellow onion. Let's turn it up a little bit higher. Put this on high and get this thing started. Now it's best always to remember, you're using a nonstick here, use a nonstick or a plastic spoon. Never use metal on nonstick. Never, ever use metal. That is a muy malo, meaning very bad. You don't want to use metal on a nonstick. That would not be good. Now you cut your onions up into strips like you see here. And you get a big mix of big pieces, small pieces, little chunks here and there, but that's all right because this is proper fajita style cut onions. And if you want to learn about real authentic Mexican cooking, you come to the right place. What am I talking in Italian for? See, this is what happens when you mix your cultures together. But anyway. And if you want to, you can have a side of refried beans or frijoles. In fact, that's not a bad idea. I think I'll make some frijoles up. Have this on the side as a... Okay. Cuando tienes muchas cebollas aquí, and one of them just leapt out on me on my foot. That is no good anymore. Even though I could have washed it off, but I got plenty of them here, so I'm not worried. Okay, so you get the real Mexican cooking over here. You know what I'm talking about? That's Italian again. Larry, you are getting to me. Hey, what are you talking about? Hey, I'm just a colleague over here. You know what I'm talking about? Hey. Thank you, Larry. So that's what happens when you have so many puppets and so many voices, you do so many cultures, and all those accents just kind of mix in at you, you know what I'm talking about? So now maybe I should do something Italian now. I'm going to talk like this, you know, with my hands like this, you know what I'm talking about? Like a regular Italian one, you know, they're talking with their hands. Tony Ringo, you know what I'm talking about, because you do it all the time, you know, you're talking with your hands. You're supposed to be talking with your mouth, you silly garbanzo bean, you know what I'm talking about? Alright, so anyway. And I'm talking about Tony Ringtail. He loves it when we make fun of him here on the show, and I just did it again. So, when you get your onions or cebollas cooking and nice and tender, then what we're going to do is we are going to add just a little sprig of garlic. Salt, that's powder, I need salt. Un poquito. ¿Dónde está mi garlico? Ah, está aquí. Está bien, está bien. Ah, no, that's onion salt. It's up here somewhere. ¿Dónde está mi garlic? It was right around.
It was right in front of your face.
Snake, it would have bit my nose off. Okay. Bueno. Ponela esta aquí en tu mano. Mira. We're going to take a little garlic salt and sprinkle it into our onions. That's all you need, just a nice sprinkle. Don't need to measure it out, just sprinkle it over. Or with as little or as much garlic as you want. Now you could add actual chopped garlic, but I just didn't have the time and I didn't really feel like going over there. Do peel a whole bunch of cloves of garlic. But if you do choose to use fresh garlic, use about 4 to 5 cloves. Really finely chopped, and use a chopper like I have. But for this onions, it's best to just cut them straight in. Just like that. Because the chopper will not give you this effect. I mean, you could just do a little light, you know, press of a button to get this effect, but I prefer to cut them because I want to see what it is I'm cutting. Not to let a machine do that. Now, if you want to use a machine to make that, you're more than entitled to. In fact, you'll chop them up a lot finer that way than you will on your knife, let me tell you. All right, so now these onions are cooking up nicely, and dig that aroma already. What you're smelling here is the beautiful aroma of sauteed onions with garlic salt and just a touch of cooking oil, vegetable oil to be exact. And once these are fully ready to go, we're gonna put them in that bowl over there, and then we'll be ready for the carne and the lima. Not to mention frijoles on the side, I say. Yes, not to mention frijoles on the side, which is refried beans. Matter of fact, we got a can of them right over here. There it is. There's my refried beans. Aquí estamos mis frijoles. Yo tengo mis frijoles. I'm gonna ponerlo aquí. And when they're ready. But this is the consistency we're looking for. Look at that. Now that's starting to brown up nicely. Got a little specks of brown here and there. That's basically what we're looking at. But we're gonna just pass this off into the bowl here. Take your lime. You're gonna take one half at a time, squeeze it right in there, but it's gonna be hot. Look at that. Sabes que está caliente, mira. Look, it's bubbling everywhere, look at that. Now squeeze the living daylights out of that lime and get all of that juice out of there because you're gonna need it. And let's turn this down just a little hair. Now take a whole handful of this carne and just drop it right in there. Now I prefer to cut them about as finely as possible, just like that. Now you're gonna get a lot of the meat juice mixed in with your lime. This is all gonna get drained out anyway, but you will have a nice strong flavor of lime. So we're gonna mix all this together until you see no red spots in your skillet. We're just gonna cook this a little bit more because I think I saw a little red there. So we're gonna go ahead and leave that in there. And while we're doing that, let's reach for our sauteed onions and put them back in to the mix with the meat. And we're gonna mix all of this together now. Extract the beans from the can. Sound effect, sound raccoon. Thank you. Usually he does that by now.
What? Usually you're the one. You're the one who wanted me to do them.
So. I know, but you usually do it right before I.
Oh, or I could always do this if I wanted to.
Okay, do it to this.
Yeah, exactly.
I am aiming to do this the hard way. You could get a spoon, but I don't want to dirty a spoon.
You're really having some problems trying to get those beans out.
Though.
Yeah, slowly.
As it's squirting bean juice all over the place. Oh, wait, it's coming. Okay, sound effect time.
Oh, wait, it's still coming.
Listen to this. Listen to that. Oh! You didn't even have to make a disgusting sound effect for that.
No.
It already did it on its own.
You just went chick, 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 chick.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to use the spoon because it has slots on the bottom for a reason. And I'm going to drain out all the juices as I spoon it up into this. And this is going to hold your wonderful fajita mix of carne and cebollas. Beautiful, beautiful fajita stuff. Now you can also add peppers. You can also add bell pepper to this, but as you know, I cannot eat peppers. Cannot put one in my mouth unless it has been processed into a salsa. But other than that, no peppers. They have to be in a mild salsa. If I even eat medium salsa, I can still taste the pepper. Okay, so get your beans. That is dry. I think it's because of I lost a lot of the juices out of there. But, okay, we're going to turn this down lower so that way it slow cooks. Perfection. Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and drain this out, and we're going to add the seasoning right now. Take your meats back into the skillet. It helps to have this bowl handy, even though not everything fit into it, but we are having some really good foods this time. Bomb still over there? No?
I don't know. I didn't see it.
That's my tomato. That's my cilantro. That's my chili. That's my mango. That's my green onion. That's my limestone. It's still
being out. Okay, channel, let's see if we can play a game playing Find the Lime. Uh-oh. No. Where'd they go? Okay, we're gonna need... Wait, did you find it? You got it?
It was underneath my cilantro. Tengo aquí. It's the lima.
Sonic wins because he found his own lime.
Sounds like a personal problem. Anyway, get rid of this bowl because you don't need it anymore. I'm gonna take our knife. We are going to cut this buggy in half. Being very careful because this is not a serrated blade. And if it needs sharpening, sharpen it first before you cut it. I sharpened this thing before, and I'm now able to cut lime. So, more lime. Only 1/3 of a cup of seasoning goes in. And that's a good thing I didn't fill this up all the way. That's about a half there, so let's go a little bit less than that for a third. And almost there. That's about it. That's about a third right there. No, that isn't. That's about a quarter. Just a tad bit more. So. Alright. Now, add a third cup of seasoning going into a pound of food, and we're just going to try it with the lime juice that we've extracted. And if we feel we need to add water, we'll add 1/2 cup of water. So that way, it doesn't all taste like water, but I don't think that will be necessary. Because this will be very seasoned with a taste of lime. And you see your lime in there. You're starting to smell a really wonderful. When you add the seasoning to this, it is starting to turn out wonderful. Now once we add the seasoning to this, we're going to check on our beans here in a moment. I had to turn the temperature way down on so I can concentrate on this. But now that this is getting ready to be cooked up once again, I just need to really coat all of your meat and onion with the seasoning. Make sure that no space is left untouched by the seasoning. And the purpose of the water is to help dissolve it. But the lime juice will do the same thing too. It looks like I'll need just a tad bit more water. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna take this and just add. I'm just gonna get 1/4 cup just for now and just add it in there. Just pour it right in there. Little at a time though, so you can see what you got to work with. And if you see that it's dissolving a lot better, as you notice, it's staying in the center. It's not coating anything else, so you need more water for that. This is 1/4 cup of water. I think that should do it. Let's see. Get that onion back in there. Get back in there. Okay. This should do it right here. Now, we're going to keep this heat. It turns back up again. We're going to keep this heat at a medium-low, about 4. In order to make this authentic, you need to add peppers, and we all know how we feel about peppers. Like, folks, if you do send in recipes that require peppers, do not expect them to be in the recipe. I will mention it, but do not expect me to use it. I cannot eat peppers. They still send it to me anyway. Hey, add 1 cup of pepper. No. You can make it fine without peppers. Peppers are always going to be optional. That is too dry for beans, so just, if your beans are too dry like that, just add a little bit of water, mix it in, and you're good to go again. Because this is the fat-free kind, and usually you rely on the bean juice to help turn this into more of a liquefied state. But if it comes out too dry and pasty like that, you just add water. And pasty would be a good thing. That's what this is turning into, is a paste. But if it comes out too dry and crumbly, that's what I meant to say, crumbly. Now that's what came out of my can over there. Just add a little water, and there you go. Nice and mushy. Don't need too much. We're not gonna drink your beans. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna prepare our pita pockets. And try to get the ones with the that do specify pockets. Pocket pita. Now we're gonna put this in the microwave here. We got a new microwave too, look at that. 1,150 watts of pure microwavable power. So what we're gonna do now is we are going to express
cook this pocket. As he breaks it later.
This is a good thing. Okay. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna cook it for about 20 seconds. And start. The thing goes around in circles, but you microwave it with the bag already in it because it gives a steaming action. And 20 seconds in here, it's going to perk them right up and they won't fall apart on you. Or at least they won't fall apart on you as if you pull them out of the refrigerator where they'd be brittle. We're going to cut it lengthwise along like that. So let's get rid of this lettuce, put that back over here, and get a knife that has a serrated blade. I'm going to take this and we're going to cut it right in half. The pocket has already been made beforehand. All you're doing is just exposing it and open it up a little, and there's your pocket. Now this is going to be kind of delicate, so you do need to heat this up. And what we're going to do, we're going to take this and some of that, the cheese and the lettuce. Now first of all, we're going to lay down our lettuce just like we did before in our chicken fajita episode. We're just going to cut this down to about the size that'll fit in here. So the lettuce will help protect the inside of your pita, and you just lay it down like that as a liner. Feel free to add as much or as little lettuce as you want. This is going to be nice and healthy, and it's going to be delicious. Sabes que muy delicioso para tu boca. It's going to be delicious for your mouth to enjoy, and your boca is going to be so feliz, and he's happy. And he's so happy that he's got all this good food. All right, so put in the dot. There we go. That's good now right there. Because remember, we got to put some of that in there too. Flinging food everywhere. Maybe it's a good thing I didn't work in a Mexican restaurant. There'd be food all over the place. And then my boss would be like, hey, you're using too much of the food, is it? I'm like, no, now it's on the floor. And just put Pico de Gallo right there. Just like that. And then, reach for your queso. That's cheese. And just take a nice pinch of cheese. Put it right over the top of your pita, and there it is. Folks, you have made yourself a combination of chicken fajita pita and carne asada burrito into a pita pocket. Now you can add salsa on the top, you can add sour cream, guacamole, anything you want. So the more you add, the less you'll have to put in. Just keep in mind that, because you don't want to overstuff your pita. And we have made carne asada fajita pita. Why do I keep coming up with complicated names? Because the complicated recipes that I have just invented. We are going to let Alan try the first one, Wolf Dog. Try this. Give me the camera. Dame la cámara. Y I'll give you the plato.
The plato?
Sí, plato.
That's an interesting way of putting it.
That's a Mexican way of putting it. So take a bite out of the first ever carne asada fajita pita.
All right, so
put some more cheese on that.
Yeah, that might be a good idea.
And then you lost the tomate. There you go. Now, get a load of this. As food dribbles all over the place. What do you think of carne asada fajita pita?
It's really good, I like it.
It's really good, whoa. That's a very good compliment. Let me turn the heat down on my food.
That would be a good idea.
So that way it simmers and it's nice and steamy. So it looks like it's a solid hit then, eh?
Oh yeah.
Now, for the chef to try his.
And you're losing cheese.
Wow. You're right, that is good. I taste pico de gallo. Lots of the cheese. Tastes a little bean in there too, but that's because I mixed it. This with bean.
Yeah.
Halligan is really going to love this fork. Mmm, that was good.
just got a bite of the meat. And the lime. Oh my god. The lime and the seasoning. Just a little bit of water to help dilute the seasoning in. Folks, my mouth is watering for another bite. Now, if you did it exactly the way I did it here, you cannot possibly mess this up. This has been Cooking with SonicBlu, and I'm going to take this and make some more. And I'm going to have this while you're sitting over there watching me eat it. Anyway, if you want to try this recipe, you can download it in our website, www.ohiopawpets.org, and I suggest you do so. And follow it along right along with your cooking buddy, SonicBlu, over here, because he's got the recipes, he's got the know-how, and he's got a little bit of interesting nature to mix two recipes together, just like we did here. So good eating, and I'll see you next time. I'll be covered with cheese, but I'll see you next time.
For complete recipes, send an email to sonicblu@yahoo.com. Thanks for watching, and remember, if you're not cooking good, you're not eating good. Bye for now.